Absolutely wonderful. So on a flight booking system, on travel system or any bid system like Orbitz or Travelocity or any other, where you're trying to make multiple bookings in one single shot. So you can select a choice of hotel, car rental and air ticket. Good example.
And even when you do a checking your profile, various industry you work in.
Another good example, so in your resume that you're trying to build a resume on online system, in that you give your preferences for industry where you would like a job. You can select pharmaceutical, select finance, select manufacturing as well. Part-time, full-time, there are several options. So, absolutely right. So now we understand the distinction where we want a radio button to be used. What is the checkbox to be used? So we understand a button, we understand an image, we understand a radio button, we also understand a checkbox. But there is another option that we have here. What is this? This is a drop down or a list of values, right? And in this list of values, what can be done? You are allowed to select the option from the existing, which means what? You are restricting the possibilities of error. And also remember, when you use the list of values as a medium to accept the choice, you can restrict the choice to one or multiple. So I can give you examples of drop-down choices where you can select more than one. So to understand this, let's walk through this again. A list of values is used to select an option or select multiple options based on requirements, right? And we also notice that the drop-down list can be numeric, can be alpha, can be alphanumeric. So what we need to understand is, what is the total number of choices available? Right?
I have a question. Here are passengers only 4. Because if it is, I have to book on I can't book it.
That's the business requirement. Or it's a bug. It can be both, right?
Yeah.
It is a business requirement that on a flight, you cannot book more than four on one ticket. That's a business requirement. Or it is a bug that they did not think about it, that there could be a team that's coming in for 20 people. They could book a flight, right? So there are options, but those options are not catered here. So when you're looking at limiting the option that you want to give to your user, you would use a list of values as an option for input. You can give them single select and multiple select, right? That is correct. That's how you use it, but you can give the option of multiple choices as well. Like in this case, in passenger, you don't need to give them one or two or three or four. There's always be a number, one or two. Where can you use multiple choice in a list of values? So you're looking at a list of values of locations. So you can select more than one by using the control key.
Yeah,
that's an option,
yeah.
Right? Any other thing that comes to your mind?
You have restriction, only you can select up to five.
Yeah,
maybe the business.
That is based on the business requirements again. But you can use this control to expand choice selection.
Right.
Also remember that this list of choices that you find here is restricted based on a certain order. It could be alpha sort or numeric sort or sort ascending or sort descending, single select, multi select. So these are some other properties that you need to understand for this object. In some cases, a list of values can expand and accept your input as another choice. In that case, the list is expandable. Right? In these cases that you're looking at, the list is restricted. But in some cases, the list is expandable. So you need to understand that also as an object. Then, we are also looking at this object. It's a button. But when you click this, a calendar object is delivered. Right? So now, what I'm going to do is, I am going to walk you through the next steps of this application. So let's say there are two passengers who are flying from Acapulco, a destination, to Zurich. And since it is a round trip, they're asking me the return ticket as well. I want to fly first class. I want to give a preference of Unified Airlines. When I click next, what do you expect to happen? The second part of the booking process, the first part is the flight finder. So I find the flight that I want to travel on that specific day. I give the choice preferences, and when I go to the next page, I find the options. So here, I select the flight. Do I prefer to use the flight? Yes. What will happen if there are multiple flights? Let's look at that. So what happened now? We have multiple flights that cater to my request, right? I can make a choice. I can make a selection of my departure flight and arriving flight, right? And then go on to the next page where passenger information is being shared. Since I booked for two passengers, it is calculating the cost for two passengers. It is giving me the price. I can give the details about the passenger here.
Priya Javalkar
has left the conference.
It is giving me the price.
Has joined the conference.
This is my second passenger. Last name of my passenger here. Meal preferences. So what are we looking at here? Based on each form, there are features related to each form that are dedicated in the entire business process. So we as quality assurance engineers, when we start working on this application, we need to test when the application is delivered to me by default, does it meet the standard expectations or not? When I mean default, it means that when I sign in, the first preference that I should see on the application caters to this. For example, as of now, if I were to test this page, I have to test the page which is served to me by default. I have not done anything on this page. As is what the page is delivered to me, I should know what it is. That's what will be a part of my requirement. When the application is invoked, this is the state of all the objects on the application. Upon login, which is user taking an action, right? This is user taking an action now. By default is stage one. Upon user interaction is stage two. What is stage three? After user's action. So after user's action, what happens? The next page is delivered. Now, when you are now on the second segment of the business process, you've been authenticated. After you're authenticated, now you are on the flight finder section of the business process. In this flight finder section, well, you'll have those three stages. First is default. What is default here? Round trip is pre-selected. Number of passengers is always one. The departing location is always the first item of the drop-down list. This is also a part of your test that you need to exercise. Then,
It will be specified.
You missed the interesting part about assumptions. We discussed that part in the morning, which was when you assume, make an ass of you and me.
Oh, that's fine. Now, I understand that. What I'm saying is...
So we don't assume anything. We base it on what the requirement is and what the design says. Because the UX, the user experience people, will define how the design will look. And they have done some market research to come out with some expected design that is appealing for the customer. Now, there could be conditions depending on where the application is being used. For example, if this application was a global application and I am looking at travel destinations of different locations on the world. In US, let's say it's summertime and Florida is the most wanted location, Disney World. I will have a business requirement which will state if a user is from Florida, then give him New York as the destination. If my user is in New York, give him Florida as the destination. It can be done. But it needs to be provided in business requirements.
What I'm trying to say here is, in case, let us say, the business that it doesn't specify. It doesn't specify anything. And when you open up, something like this comes up, then is it considered as a bug?
It's a blank.
Is it considered as a bug?
From the drop-down.
Let us say my business DRD doesn't tell you the first. Let us say this is going in a chronological order. So the first departing should always, the first thing in the list, the last thing is something starting with B. Okay?
So it's an alpha sort.
Alpha sort.
Okay.
But the specification, but my DRD doesn't say it. DRD business requirement document doesn't say it has to be, it just says this departing time, as departing from place has to be displayed when you open up the screen. And this is,
they do not mention it in the BRD, no. Let me walk you through what will happen in this case.
Mm-hmm.
When you're looking at your business requirements document, and the business requirement document is silent about this, right? It does not specify what should be the first displayed object.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a question of selection.
Right.
It's a question of display sequence, right?
Mm-hmm.
In this case, it is not selected. It is the default rendered.
Right.
Since you do not have an expectation, you will not have a test case to test it. Because what are you testing? The functionality works as expected.
Right.
So if it is not expected for you to validate this,
mm-hmm.
why would you be testing it? So there should be no test case for this.
I don't even care about it.
Logically, there should be no test case even if this condition is not to be tested. But you can always seek clarification on the BRD.
Right.
Now, that's where you have typically gap analysis. Good that you brought it up. That my requirement that I am thinking is needed is not listed as expected. So what are you expecting me to do? This is where the quality assurance getting engaged in the requirement collection phase itself becomes helpful. So quality assurance team is validating your requirements and saying this requirement is not testable because I do not have the requisite information.
Mm-hmm.
Make sense? So that's how you handle this. But if it is a part of your design document, it will mention that this should be the default option. User should be able to select single or multiple.
Mm-hmm.
And when you submit, this is what is expected. So now, going back to what we were doing, we have to look at the application.